Could coal fires or subterranean rocks yield tomorrow's cancer drugs? Maybe, says UK pharmaceutical researcher Jon Thorson. He's looking for natural products in Kentucky's unique environments.
Natural products, they're basically molecules that have evolved for function over time. And historically, they've probably been found most in the area of cancer and infectious disease. You can make very minor changes to molecules that we already know, and that can lead to very dramatic changes in potency, the way that the molecules behave in the body. A lot of these structures they're very complex, and so to approach them from a traditional synthetic strategy is a very lengthy and difficult process. So if you can instead manipulate the natural machinery that generates these molecules, it may provide a really rapid way to do medicinal chemistry. In terms of novel scaffolds, that's sort of more the holy grail. That's where we feel that you may have a leg up if you're starting with unusual organisms and things that people have not investigated before.
Thorson is partnering with Jim Hauer at the Center for Applied Energy Research to get samples from underground coal fires.
Jim studies basically underground coal fires and the emissions from these underground coal fires.
In February of 2012, John dropped me an email and described what he was doing, and it basically asked if I was interested in participating, and I invited him out to my laboratory, CAR. We talked about the types of places that I would go. Mutually, we decided that the coal fire sites were a very good starting point because they are fairly unique. Everywhere there is coal, you've got that potential because coal will burn. The ones in eastern Kentucky, we tend to believe, got started by way of forest fires or fires started by lightning strikes. And then once they're started, particularly when they're in these abandoned mines, there's so many access points for air. You just cannot feasibly plug up all the holes, basically wait until the coal runs out. The Lots Creek fire, so it was first reported late 2011. So we made a couple of visits to do our gas sampling in 2012, made another visit with John to collect samples for the pharmacy study. Sites really vary considerably, and they're going to vary considerably from visit to visit because they're very dynamic locations. Obviously, if things are on fire underground, they're burning through maybe old coal pillars, which then once they're burned out are going to collapse. The fire kills the tree roots and other plants, so we have trees falling and certainly going to change the runoff, which definitely could affect people downhill and down the valley from these places. Really, any place around that vent that's been heated, whether it's soil or some of the minerals that have been volatilized and come out of the gases, condensed out either on a rock surface or on tree roots, is really a prime target for sampling.
And then Jim has helped facilitate connections with some of the mining operations in the Commonwealth, and also put us in touch with the KGS, and which is one of our most recent collection sites in the core drilling operation.
In April 2013, the Kentucky Geological Survey drilled a 4,800-foot deep well in the eastern Kentucky coal field to analyze the potential of underground rocks to hold carbon dioxide. More than 40 core samples from multiple depths were taken and sent to Thorson. At the Center for Pharmaceutical Research and Innovation, Thorson's team takes a small sample, puts it on a media plate, purifies it, and looks for unique molecules.
A lot of these organisms are very slow-growing organisms. And so you're talking about months to get you to a point where you're finally getting extracts and you start to look at the profile. At that point, you can at least prioritize your cultures based on chemical novelty. The final step is to try to then put these compounds into repositories made available to investigators on the UK campus so that they can access them and enter them into some of their studies. Our program has really only been in place for a little over a year, but we've had a fair bit of success already. The 60 compounds in our repository have all come from microbes that were found in the Commonwealth. And then my lab has developed a number of different technologies for taking a natural product and further diversifying it. It's using enzymes, so we can take one molecule and blow it up into a larger array of structures. Natural products have been and continue to be a driving force in drug discovery. The hope would be that some of these may eventually come out of the coal mines here in the Commonwealth.